A relatively impressive performance in the recently concluded Emirates Invitational Sevens in Dubai. The Rugby Crane Sevens have now returned guns to the forthcoming World Rugby Seventh Olympic qualifier, scheduled from the 19th to 20th June in Monaco, France. Here's the report.
At the Emirates Invitational Sevens, Uganda finished 6th out of the 8 Rugby Sevens playing nations that took part in a 2-week tournament. The Rugby Crane Sevens returned back on last Saturday after the tournament climaxed on 9th April.
You can actually go to a tournament and you're like 9 players. Not because you're injured, but because probably some guys are caught up in quarantine and stuff like that, and it affects the team.
It was a tournament meant to gauge us on what we need to work on and what we are doing good. So far, what we are doing good, we already know. We just need a few things to polish a few things.
Adrian Kasito, one of the long-serving players on the national team, attributes the low performance on COVID-19 outbreak.
Because it had been a full year without playing competitively with the top sides, and we had also just started training, like about three months of training, then we went into a tough tournament.
However, he calls for the government full intervention on issues concerning sports and rugby in general.
It's more of a wake-up call. Man, things out there are really hot, and fans out here never get to know the reality. They never get to know what actually happens in camp.
Kasito outlines what should be done for future teams' good performance.
Personally, I believe we just need to play in more tournaments. That's all we need. More tournaments.
The Emirates Invitational Tournament in Dubai served as an eye-opener to other Rugby Sevens tournament organizers that had put tools down due to COVID-19.
I believe other tournaments are going to start happening. Though I don't think fans will be let into the stadiums.
Uganda Rugby Crane Sevens 2020 Olympic qualification now lies in the players' intensive training that is set ahead of them in 2 weeks' time by the team head coach Tolbert Onyango.